Hey guys, I'm not going to show any tactics today with the grappling dummy. What I'm going to talk to you about is about how to learn your skills. I always hear from people who say they can't remember the techniques or they've forgotten more techniques than they've learned. And people beat themselves up all the time. They think that there's something wrong with them, that they can't remember their tactics or they can't grapple as well as they'd like to. Well, if you're involved in martial arts, you're involved in skill learning. And there's a real art and science to skill learning. Just like anything else, like taking a trip. If you try to, you're trying to get from point A to point B. You're trying to get from where you're at now to being a more skilled grappler. Anytime you're trying to get from one place to another, you need some type of a map to follow. You can get there, just you know, without following a map, but it's probably going to take you a lot longer and be a whole lot more frustrating than if you're otherwise, if you had a map to follow, a roadmap, and we're doing it the right way. So anyways, let's talk about how you learn a skill. When you learn a skill, there's three stages that you have to go through, and you really can't shortcut this. These stages, you may be gifted and get through one stage quicker than another, or quicker than other people, but you have to go through these stages. The first one is the relatively short stage. It's called the cognitive phase, and that's the phase where you're just trying to understand the pieces that go into performing the tactic, a skill. And by the way, what I'm talking about here applies to grappling, it applies to striking, it applies to learning to play the piano, anything you're doing. So it's a great idea to really understand how to do this. Now that cognitive phase, you're just trying to understand the pieces of it. A good example of that would be if you've ever done a triangle choke or an arm bar. You were trying to fit pieces together. I mean, I can give you an example here. I'll try it on the dummy. So, for example, with a arm bar, depending on how you do it, you may have learned the way of doing a five-step, where you go grab the wrist, grab the elbow, foot to the ground or the hip, pivot, foot over, and that's five moves. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, you're trying to fit five pieces together. So you're not really doing one thing, you're doing five. So in that cognitive phase, that first phase, you're trying to just understand what those pieces are. Now an essential part, and this is really important, an essential part of that is that you have to be able to see those pieces in your mind. You've got to be able to visualize them before you can do it. So think about that. If you can't see it, if you can't picture it in your mind, what are you trying to imitate? You have to have some image in your head of what you're trying to perform. Otherwise, you don't know what you're doing. So if you sit down with a grappling partner and you go, okay, let's rep this out, and you're trying, and you can't do it, well, yeah, you're frustrated because you don't even know what you're trying to do. So here's an idea. You may want to try just sitting back, learning it, just slowing your roll a little bit and go, okay, let me picture this in my head. And just sit back and try to visualize, try to picture the movements. Once you can picture them all, you understand it. Until then, you don't understand. So that can be a good way to help that phase, all right, and to improve your learning. Now, some people will stop right there. I mean, it sounds a little ridiculous, but some people go, okay, I know it, I get it. You know, they've got the pieces, and so they think they've got the tactic. That's a pretty low level of learning. So going to the second phase. The second phase is called the associative phase. And that's where you start to link all the pieces together from the tactic. So with five-step armbar, for example, it becomes, instead of five pieces, you start to see it as one thing. All right, so to get through the associative phase, what's really required is repetition. There's no other way of doing it. So that's when you're working on focusing on repetition to build muscle memory. One of the reasons why a grappling dummy is great is because you can just do repetition. You're not trying to apply the tactic, you're just trying to link those pieces together in the physical world, not just in your mind, but physically trying to link them together. So that's the associative phase. A lot of people stop somewhere in there. I can't tell you how many times I've taught relatively new students, and they will do something three or four times and then say, okay, I've got it, what's next? And that's just ridiculous. So you're nowhere near having it after three or four repetitions. You know, 300 or 400, now you're starting to get some good inroads into muscle memory, but not three or four repetitions. So once you've got through the associative phase, that phase where you've done a lot of reps, you've done high reps, now you're getting to the point where you're starting to enter into the, it's called the autonomous phase. And the autonomous phase is where it happens on its own. In other words, you're doing the action without even really thinking about it. You may perceive the stimulus to the action, to cause you to do the action. What I mean is, for example, you're mounted on an opponent, and he puts the arm up, so you saw the stimulus to cause a response from you. You saw the arm come up, but the response comes more out of your subconscious. You don't consciously think, oh, there's an arm. I mean, think, oh yeah, I should go for the arm bar. You really only think about it after it's already happened. Like, wow, what just happened? I just did this. So that's called the autonomous phase, and that's where you're really getting high level skill. A good example would be if you're playing basketball, or probably a better example is riding a bike. When you're a kid, you start off and you're in that cognitive phase. You know, you realize, okay, I got to get on this thing, and I got to, you know, hold the handles, put my feet on the pedals, and you know, you're just trying to understand what's involved there. And then your parents helping you, they're walking behind you with the bike, holding onto the bike. And so you're starting to get some repetition. If you were to stop at that phase early in the repetitive phase, in the associative phase, without getting to the point where you can do it without thinking, 10 years down the road, you try to do it again, you won't be able to ride the bike, right? It's like starting over. If you take it to the point where you don't no longer think, you just go, I'm going to go for a nice ride, and I'm looking at the scenery, and there's no thought at all going on about how to operate the bike, then you've got it. Now you own it for life, and you're not going to forget it. You may lose your ability a little bit over the years. 10 years later, though, you can get on a bike and ride it. You know, same thing with basketball. You play basketball so much as a child. You know, you don't play as an adult, and then somebody throws you a ball, and you're out on the court, and you're dribbling and shooting. You know, you can be off your game a bit, but you still have game. A lot of people in grappling never get to that phase. Now, there's a reason for that. You can get away without getting to the autonomous phase because grappling moves relatively slow. For example, you get a mount or a crossbow on a person, you're holding them, and he's reaching around your neck or he presents his arm to you. You go, oh, I've got his arm. You can grab hold of the arm. And then you have time actually to sit and think about it. Think, oh, yeah, I got to wrap my arm here and grab it. And that's why you can, against somebody else who's relatively lower level, or a guy on the street who doesn't know anything, you can get away without getting into the autonomous phase because you actually have more time to think. Not true in a striking sense situation. Think of a good boxer who slips and ducks, punches and counters. He's not thinking about each punch. Okay, that's all coming out of the subconscious. He may see the punch, but the reaction comes out of the subconscious. So just so you understand, with grappling, yeah, you can get away with being a little bit lower level in the skill learning process. Whereas with a striking art, you can't be. Or you need to be at the point where you're able to respond, and afterwards you go, oh, look what I just did, not think about what you're about to do. So I hope that gives you a little bit of help on understanding the processes you're going to go through. It's really important, both as a student and possibly more important as a teacher, to understand this. Because you need to understand where you're at in the process, and as a teacher, you need to understand where your students are so you don't bog them down and you aren't giving them tactics that are just going to take them off of where they're at or shortcut that. Maybe they're in the second stage or still in the first stage, you're giving them new material, and they're trying to work on that, and they never really got through the whole learning process. So you don't want to do that to yourself either. I've got a little more to talk about on this, but we'll save that for next time. So hope this helps you. Good training.